this piece of paper gives off electromagnetic radiation. This block of wood gives off electromagnetic radiation. This dry erase racer gives off electromagnetic radiation. And if you're okay with this, you should be able to get the questions right on the test. But that's kind of not the point here. You need to embrace this with your heart and your soul. Let's move forward. 1890. The physicists of the late 19th centuries were surprisingly good at spectroscopy. They knew that the electromagnetic radiation covered a wide range of frequencies. They knew that the frequencies were related to energy, so that the electromagnetic radiation was a range of energies. They knew that visible light was a narrow band within this much broader range, and they knew that infrared radiation was off the low energy end, and ultraviolet radiation was off the high energy end. And furthermore, they knew that ordinary objects give off infrared radiation. But the thing they didn't understand was, what is electromagnetic radiation? They knew it was a wave. In the 1890s, physics was dominated by the work of a 15th century English scientist named Sir Isaac Newton. Newtonian physics is all about things that can be seen and things that can be understood. So waves, well, waves are like a guitar string twanging, or like wiggling a rope, like swinging a jump rope. So what are electromagnetic waves anyway? They must be things that wiggle, according to Newtonian physics. So things wiggle and they make electromagnetic waves. And so if you take an object, like a clay pot might be a good object, or maybe a piece of metal or something, and heat it up, the infrared radiation should turn into red light. And then if you keep heating it, the red light should turn into green light. It should go into higher energies. It should turn green. And then if you keep heating it, it should go to blue light. And then if you keep heating it, it ought to go to ultraviolet light and perhaps not give off visible light at all once it gets hotter than the appropriate temperatures. But the problem is that the observations didn't demonstrate that. The observations are that an object, when heated, turns red, red hot. And then as you keep heating it, the green light and the blue light appear simultaneously. The red light doesn't go away. And the result of this is that it turns white. So it pretty much goes from red hot to white hot. And ultraviolet radiation, it never gives off ultraviolet radiation, no matter how hot you heat it. So how can this be explained? They had a name for it at the time. This was well understood within the physics community in the 1890s. The ultraviolet catastrophe was that the observations did not fit Newtonian physics. Max Planck was a German scientist. He was a chemist in Germany. He was an energy guy. He was interested in like enthalpy and entropy and Gibbs free energy and all that hard stuff that's in physical chemistry textbooks. He, as far as I can tell, had no knowledge or information or interest in molecular structure. Atomic structure wasn't his thing. The electromagnetic radiation was not his thing either, as far as I can tell. He was an energy guy. He looked at the ultraviolet catastrophe and made a jump. He jumped off into the unknown and said that light is a quanta. It's kind of like a thing. Green light is green light. Green light doesn't come from red light. Green light is a thing on its own. I think that one of the great educators of our era is Bill Nye. Bill Nye says everything is either matter or energy. So I listen to this, matter or energy. So energy includes energy. So energy is a thing. And I think it goes back to Max Planck. Max Planck says that energy is a thing. Green light is a thing. Red light is a thing. Red light and green light aren't the same thing, never will be the same thing. And then the behavior of black body radiation, you heat something up and it gives off red light. The red light comes from something, and then you heat it up even further and it gives off green light. Green light comes from something different. Blue light, you heat it up even further and it starts giving off blue light, and blue light is something yet different still. And no matter how hot you heat it, whatever gives off infrared radiation, whatever gives off ultraviolet radiation, never happens. And Max Planck doesn't dive into the what's and how's of them on the molecular level. He's an energy guy. The quantum mechanical revolution comes from Max Planck, and it's interesting that he didn't have anything to do with atomic structure. He comes up with a new idea of energy. He says energy is a thing. I want to end with this image. You have a red flashlight. You take the red flashlight into outer space for simplicity. Shine the red flashlight out into the emptiness of space. The red light leaves the flashlight. The red light goes and goes and goes as red light. It doesn't turn into green light. It doesn't turn into blue light. It doesn't tire out. It doesn't go away. The red light is a thing, just like this piece of paper is a thing. It's a thing. And it, nothing happens to it unless it interacts with something. 100 million years from now, the red light that left the flashlight is still going to be going somewhere. The relevance of this is completely overwhelming, but I think one aspect we can look at right now is that here on the planet Earth, we look at a star that's 100 million light years away. We're looking at radiation that came from that star 100 million years ago. By looking at that radiation carefully, we can tell all kinds of things about the star. We can find out all kinds of things about this star as it was 100 million years ago, because that's when the light left the star. I think it's cool. And trust me on this one. That test you're about to take, it's not as important as you think.